This is part one of using the Pythagorean theorem. In this video, we'll briefly go over the Pythagorean theorem and then use it to find the exact and approximate lengths of the missing sides shown on the two right triangles here. In this video, I'll be briefly going over the Pythagorean theorem, one of the most famous theorems in math, and then we will be using the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of a missing side of a right triangle. So first of all, I have a little picture of a right triangle. A right triangle means you have one 90 degree angle. So this right here is a 90 degree angle. Okay, and we usually use this little symbol to show that. So you notice we've got three sides. The two smaller sides would be A and B. Those are the lengths of the smaller sides of the triangle, and the long side is the hypotenuse. So this longer side is called the hypotenuse. And interestingly enough, if you have a right triangle, if you take the length of the shorter side and square it, and you add it to the length of the other side, not the hypotenuse, but the other side squared, it's the same as the length of the hypotenuse squared. So this is basically the Pythagorean theorem. If we have a right triangle and we have two legs, A and B are legs. They're the lengths of the legs. Okay. So we're going to square each leg, add them together. It's the same as the square of the hypotenuse, okay, that length. Now, this really comes from area. So I'm going to give you just a real brief look at this, and then you could see another video to see a proof of this. So real quickly, if we look at this triangle again, imagine if we made a square that had for its side the hypotenuse, so each side would be C. And we did the same thing for both legs. So we took a square over here, so that means the length of this other side would also be A, and then we took a square on this side B, and this length would be BB. If we look at the area of each of the squares, I'm going to put the area as the side squared, C by C. The area of this square would be C squared, the area of this square would be A squared, and the area of this square would be B squared. It so happens that if you take each of these areas, the A squared and B squared, and put them together, it happens to be the same as the area of this square of the hypotenuse. Okay, so if you actually measured the area of a right triangle, you measured these squares, that's where the Pythagorean theorem really comes from. It's talking about the area of those squares. Right, now what we can do is use this to solve some right triangles. So let's say we're looking at this right triangle, and you notice I don't have anything for this longer leg. So let's say I want to find out how long that would be. I'm just going to call that X. You could call it A or B as well. Basically, I've got 5 inches for the shorter side, 8 inches for the hypotenuse. And what we're saying is if we square each of the sides, each of the legs and add it together, this is really in inches, so in the end, whatever we get for X, we'll have to put in inches. We add the squares of the legs, the lengths of the legs, we get the same thing as the square of the hypotenuse, which is 8 squared. Okay? Now we want to solve for x, so I need to write x squared plus 25 equals 64. You first have to square the 5 and square the 8. And then we're going to subtract 25 from both sides. So that gives us x squared equals, let's see, that's going to be 39. So what it's saying is that this side squared equals 39. What it's saying is if you made a big square here off of the x, where one side was x, the area of that square would be 39. So what you're trying to find out is how long is x? Now, we know when we square the number, we get 39, so x must be the square root of 39, since we're looking for the length. So x is simply the square root of 39. Now you want to convince yourself that that's true. A little quick check is if you took square root of 39 and you squared it, remember you would get 39? So that's where I'm getting this idea from. When you square the square root, you get 39. So if x squared is 39, then x is the square root of 39. Now, we're talking about how long this side is, so we would say x is, you know, square root of 39 inches, right? So that's the exact length of this missing side. But it would be good to have an approximation. So what we could do is use our calculator to find out approximately what the square root of 39 is. Now, we know that the square root of 36 is 6, and so this, I'm guessing it's going to be a little bit over 6. So let's get out a calculator and check that out. So here's a calculator. It's just a cheap, you know, run of the brand calculator. I'm going to put in 39, and then I'm going to press the square root key, which is right here. Notice I get this huge thing, 6.244997. I don't even know if you could read that. But you could decide if you want to estimate it to one or two decimal places, etc. But what we could do is write down that x is approximately equal to 6.2 inches because the calculator actually had 6.24, etc. So I rounded it. So it's approximately 6.2. Now we look at their picture and we say, does that look like a reasonable length for this side of x? Certainly. Remember, if you add two sides, the two legs together have to be more than the hypotenuse, okay? So if I add 5 and 6, I get 11. It's bigger than 8. Everything seems reasonable. So let's look at another problem. All right, this time we have another right triangle, and we don't know the length of the hypotenuse. I'm going to let that be h, just to remind myself that's the hypotenuse. Some people like to do c, thinking c is the length of the hypotenuse. So we start out the same way. We take the square of each leg and add them together. So the 3 squared plus the 5 squared has got to be the h squared. Okay. Now that does not mean that 3 plus 5 equals h. In fact, you should convince yourself that h is much shorter than 8, because the long way would be going 3 this direction and 5 this direction, and this is a shortcut, so it should be certainly less than 8. So we have to square the 3, square the 5, so we have 9 plus 25 equals h squared, and then we have to add those together. And then by the same reasoning, if h squared is 34, what number squared would give you 34 that would be a positive number? It would have to be the square root of 34. So I'm going to write that h would be the square root of 34. Now, I didn't put inches, so and I didn't put feet, so it would just be square root of 34. If we were talking about a real object, of course, this would have feet or millimeters or centimeters, etc. So now let's approximate it. So approximate it to one decimal place, we want to figure out what the square root of 34 is. Now in that last problem, we had the square root, I think, of, what was it? I think it was 39, and we know that that was a little bit more than 6. Notice, square root of 34 is a little less than the square root of 36. Square root of 36 is 6. So you know what? This is probably going to be a little bit under 6, 5 point something. So again, you want to get out your calculator, plug in 34, do the square root, and see what happens. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to put in 34. I'm going to press the square root, and I get 5.83095, and it goes on and on and on. So if we want to approximate it, let's say, to one decimal place, to tenths, I'm going to say it's approximately 5.8. Okay? Now, if there would not have been a variable here, it really makes sense if somebody says, what's the length of the missing side? And the original problem had nothing there. You would just say the missing side. The exact answer is square 34. And the approximation to, let's say, the nearest tenth is 5.8. If I would have talked about feet, then this would also be in feet. That's the little mark for feet. You could either use that little mark, or you could write out feet. If you're doing a problem where you might get something like square root of 12, you would want for the exact answer to simplify the square root of 12 to something like 2 squareds of 3. But square root of 34 cannot be simplified. We'll do problems like that on the next video.